Sometimes moms and dads fall out of love. Sometimes two homes are better than one. Some things you can't tell your sister, cause she's still too young. Yeah, you'll understand when you love someone.
Hey guys, it's Juls. Welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if this is the first time you're seeing my videos. And if it is, you should totally hit the subscribe button down below so you don't miss any of my videos. And today I don't usually do this, usually I just do vlogs, but today I'm doing a kind of vlog and experience video because I think the vlog would just be too short since it was kind of a short vlog, but it was an interesting experience. So I'm gonna just do a vlog slash experience, so I'll put in clips as I speak. So basically, this Thursday, so today's Saturday, so like 3 days ago, I met and like actually got to like see perform and like not like fully talk to, but like we talked a bit, like often, whatever, you'll see in the story, but like I got to like, it was a great experience. So I got to kind of meet and talk to James CW, and if you don't know who he is, he's a really 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 talented singer. He opened for Shawn Mendes last year. That's how I found out about him, but I'm really glad I did because he's really really sweet and talented and whatever. If you don't know who he is, definitely go check him out. He's coming out with new music next Friday, so he played the new music when I saw him on Thursday, and it's really really good, so I'm really excited for that. You guys should all go check him out. And anyway, with enough of me rambling, make sure to follow my social media down below as always, and let's get into the video. Bye! So this all started on Wednesday morning when I woke up and I was checking Snapchat, and I saw on the Snapchat story, he said LA to Chicago, and he doesn't come to Chicago that much, so I was really intrigued because I really want to see him again. I met him once at the Chicago World Tour for Shawn Mendes because he did a meetup like before the show. I really wanted to meet him and see him again, but I wasn't gonna just like ditch school and like go walk around Chicago to try to find him because that would be impossible and a waste of my time, honestly. But I tweeted him saying, you know, he should do a meetup or a concert or something or like a show because I did really want to see him and meet him. And so I was going through school, nothing really happened. I was talking to my friends about how I really wanted to see him. I DM'd some of my internet friends saying, like, if he does something in Chicago, I really want to go because I really miss him. And I think it was, like, the afternoon of Wednesday when I was coming back from my dentist appointment or something. And my friends were DMing me. They kept sending me his tweet saying that he was going to do a meetup in Chicago at 12 p.m. at the Bean on Thursday. And they were like, you have to go. Like, you have to go meet him. And obviously, I really wanted to. And my mom, like, isn't so inclined to be missing school, obviously. So she was like, maybe, I don't know, like, I don't want to call you out. Like, it's not, like, the best idea. Like, you'll be talking to him for, like, 10 seconds, and it's just, she didn't know if it was worth it. So, but she kind of got my hopes up by saying maybe. So the whole night, I was, like, really excited. Like, she told me she would tell me at the end of the night, and then the end of the night came, and she said I couldn't go because she didn't think it was worth it. So I was really, really upset about that. I tweeted how I was like sad and how I really wanted to meet him, and I like tweeted James saying, you know, like, change the meetup to like 4 or 5 or something so I can come. And then I wake up in the morning, you know, still kind of sad, but it kind of came out, like, wore off a little bit, but I was still sad. And I get some DMs from people saying that they have extra tickets to go see him if I want to see and meet him. And I was confused because I didn't know what was happening. Like, I didn't know he was doing a show, but apparently he was doing a radio kind of lounge show thing where you meet him and you see him talk for do a Q&A and see him perform for a little bit. And this was at 2 o'clock, so it was still during school, but it was towards the end of school. And so I was like, wow, like I really want to go to this. My mom, like, again said maybe because it seemed a bit different and a bit better because I wouldn't just be meeting him for 1 minute, I'd be seeing him perform and like more. And it was also towards the end of school, so it was kind of in the morning. So throughout the morning I was stressing out about this because the people who DM'd me, like, they had school, so they couldn't really reply. So I was, like, stressing out, like, they're not replying, like, not blaming them. Obviously, they had school. But I was, like, you know, I just have to wait until they reply. Like, there's nothing else I can do. So, because I had to wait for them to say yes, and then, like, wait for them to, like, confirm that I could come, and then ask my mom, and then wait for her, and then get all the details. So it was a lot of work, so I was stressed out about it. But then it was, like, a little before 9, and I got a DM from someone else, Adriana, and she said, do you want to see James today? And I was, like, oh my gosh, like, yes, I do, because the other people weren't replying. So, I made a plan, and she was telling me, like, what would happen. Like, I'd go there, be there, check in at 1:30, all that kind of stuff. I was like, okay, so this sounds great, let me just ask my mom. And so I text my mom, and I think she had, like, a meeting or something, because she wasn't able to reply for, like, an hour and a half. So, whichever, it was just fine, it ended up working out. So, an hour and a half later, I was really, like, anxious, but I didn't know if she was going to say yes or not, because I would have to miss school. But I told her, I'm ahead in my classes, I will make up all the work. Like, I'm a good student. I would make up all the work. I told her that. And so when she replied, she I saw she had long texts, and I was like, oh my gosh, this is probably a good sign, like she has a whole plan for me or something. And it was true, so she had a whole plan for what I was going to do, when I was going to leave school, how I was going to get to the radio station. And so then, like, I was freaking out in class because, like, I was going to go meet James, and I was just so excited. So then I went to lunch because lunch was my next period, and I was telling my friends how my mom was, like, let me, like, go, and I got tickets from one of my internet friends. It was just really great. And I was really thankful for my mom to, like, letting me, like, look for calling me out of school. And obviously she wouldn't have done this if, like, she didn't think I was going to make up the work, so it wasn't, like, whatever. So she could trust me, so I'm really thankful that, like, I'm a good student, so that she knows, so that I could do this kind of stuff every once in a while. So anyway, I went, after lunch, I went to one more period, and then I left school, and I took an Uber to the radio station place, and it was really confusing to find, by the way, but we found it. And so we got checked in, I was someone's plus one, and we were waiting there for, like, I don't know, like 20 minutes or so.
Okay, guys.
My hair is greasy, but, like, we live our life.
This is the first part of the vlog. So basically we're waiting for them to bring us up to meet Sean, James. Sean. Yeah, I would wish. I mean, I love James.
Damn,
I
also good. Wish Sean we were there. Meeting Sean.
For real.
So hi. There's like a bunch of girls here.
Hi.
So I'll keep y'all updated. Sounds so weird. I'm never saying that again. I say y'all when I type a lot, but it sounds weird when I don't type.
I went to Florida to visit my best friend, and I went down there, and I went to like a party with her. And like they were all like, oh my gosh, where are you from? And I was like, Chicago. They're like, I love your accent.
I'm like, I know, but like,
I was like, there is no accent.
Hi guys.
Okay, so they just came and gave us lemonade. Look how cute it is. It's so cute. Oh, is this backwards on the camera? I don't know. So we're just waiting for them to take us somewhere. I don't really know what's happening.
We have so many interests.
Thank you.
I saw James walk by, and I was like, oh my gosh, and he was like, hi, like, I'll see you guys in a few minutes. Yeah, this guitar, he was really cute, and I was like, oh my gosh. So then they took six of us at a time, and we kind of, not pushed away, there weren't that many people there, but we kind of got to the front so we could be the first six to go down to, like, where we were seeing him perform and stuff. So we were the first six, and we got front row, so we were in the front, and I was kind of in the center, which was really cool. And I think I said on my Twitter that there were like 30 people there, but I think I was looking back at the pictures on the website. I think there's only like 18 people there, which I'm not like putting down for James or anything. I'm just saying, like, that's really cool because it was really like intimate and wasn't like a huge thing, which is really cool and really great. I was front, and I was freaking out, and I was like posting pictures on Twitter, like, look how close I am, like, I'm gonna like meet him, and it was really great. And then the announcer person came on that was going to ask some questions later, and that was kind of like the host person. And these other two girls, they were like, we have a vlog, like, can James say hi to our vlog or something? And he was like, oh, really? Like, what's your channel or something? And so they told him what their channel was and then what their names were. And I was like, oh, wait, like, maybe this is my chance, you know, to get James to say hi. Like, James wasn't out yet, but they were kind of like before. So I was like, oh, I also am doing a vlog and I have a YouTube channel. He's like, how many people have a YouTube channel here? But it was just me and the other two girls. So I said my channel name and whatever. And I always feel weird saying my channel name because I feel like if I say Juls Baby, people are gonna spell it like the normal way of spelling baby. So I feel like I have to spell it out afterwards. So you'll see in the clip, but I just spelled it out afterwards for some reason.
What's yours?
It's Juls Baby, so J-U-L-S space B-B-Y.
Okay, we'll work on that. Cool. My name is Rufio, 103.5 Kiss FM. Thanks for coming out to our Sprite Lounge today. You guys are in for a special treat. Got a special guest here. He's actually going to perform a couple songs. We're going to ask him some questions. So without further ado, guys, make some noise for James T.W.
But anyway, after that, he came on. It was really sweet. And he sang When You Love Someone in his new song, X. And I always love When You Love Someone. That's just always a great song. And then, oh my gosh, I'm going to insert a quick, like a small clip of him, his new song, X. And it's so good. And like, I'm really excited for it next week, so you guys should all go buy it. I know I'm definitely gonna buy it. So we sang those two songs, and it was really great, and I'm sure I put some clips of it in here just now.
Hello, you guys.
Hey.
Hello, Maggie and Shay. Where are you guys? I'm gonna play a couple of songs, and this first one's called When You Love Someone. And this song is about when I used to teach
Kids had to play instruments a few years ago, and one of my pupils was teaching him drums when I found out his parents were gonna get divorced, and he didn't know it was gonna happen, so I wanted to write a song for him, and that would make the situation a little easier. Here it goes.
Gonna change with your old friend. Your arm will stay the same, cause you'll only be away on the weekend. It don't make sense, but nevertheless, you gotta believe us, it's all for the best. It don't make sense, don't add up, but we'll always love you, no matter what. Sometimes more than that. For that of love, sometimes two homes are better than one. Some things you can't tell sister, cause she's still too young. You'll understand when you love someone. You think they're trying to help, introducing me to someone else. I play along cause I haven't got the heart to tell them that if I dance with somebody, I might want somebody else. And if I want somebody, I might fall in love and forget what it was to be wrapped in your arms so tightly, to be your man. So tonight I'll be dancing alone, cause I'm afraid if I forget, then you'll just become an ex, or just another ex.
And then after that, the host person came back on, he asked him a few questions, and he talked about how Sean found out about him, so he was part of his tour after that, and he talked about what he said he liked ping pong, like for like what is, he answered like a bunch of random questions.
Okay, and you, I read online that you played in your dad's wedding band?
I did, yeah. So my dad plays kind of lead guitar in a wedding band with his mates. He has a normal job as well, but he does that for fun. And when I was growing up, you know, I went to their shows, and he saw on the news that drumming was really good for stress, and he obviously wasn't enjoying work at the time, it seems. So he bought a kit, and he didn't really take to it, but I loved playing the drums. So, and then the drummer, a day before one of their shows, couldn't make the show, so it was either let the 10-year-old player or it was cancelled the show. And I stepped in, and that's really when I started performing, and I still remember it. I stayed up way past my bedtime, and my dad offered me Red Bull. I was like, this is rock star. This is rock star to me right here. So
did he pay you? Did you get paid?
My neighbours did, actually. My neighbours were at the wedding, and they gave me 15 quid, which I thought was pretty good for 10-year-old. I thought that was solid.
I have no, what's a quid?
Oh, 15 quid is like pounds. It's like $20, I'd okay. say. There you go.
Not bad for your first gig, there you go.
Yeah, no, I was really happy. Meet with record labels, I was unsigned and trying, there's lots of cameras out now. and I was, you know, meeting record labels and trying to get signed. And when I was out there, Sean, I didn't know, but Sean had been watching my YouTube channel and was kind of a fan of my videos. So he tweeted out and just gave me a shout out, basically. It was really, really nice. And then from there, he wanted to meet up. So we met up and I met his label and ended up signing to the same label.
And you opened up for him on his last tour, right?
The last tour, yes.
Nice. That's pretty cool. Like Shawn Mendes, you know, kind of got his start that same way.
Right.
Social media. Was it Vine?
It was Shawn Mendes, right?
Vine.
It was Vine.
Yeah. RIP to Vine. And now he's like helping, you know, other people out like you.
Right.
When's the last time you talked to Shawn Mendes?
Today, actually.
Oh.
I sent him on his FaceTime. It wasn't FaceTime. He's busy, but...
Oh, he's busy.
You want him on FaceTime right now? No. I sent him X just to see what he thought.
Okay.
And he's a fan, so...
Yeah?
Yeah.
Cool. You guys gonna do some collab? Is he gonna be on the album, maybe?
We kind of started writing some things together on the last... But I'm not promising anything.
He's not promising anything, so don't get mad at James if Shawn Mendes is not on the album, right?
I'm gonna get mad at you.
Okay. As long as you put him in like the thank yous, I think they'll be happy. You know, like thanks to Shawn Mendes as well, and Rufio for not getting mad at everybody.
It was pretty quick, like this whole thing, like the songs, the meet and greet, the Q&A, it was all like 30 minutes, so it wasn't like, it was really quick. But anyway, after he answered a few questions, they did a meet and greet, so they took the chairs off the stage, and you just come on the stage, and you get in pairs, so like it was a two people meet and greet. and you just, you know, meet him, maybe say a few things to him. But before that happened, the two girls that had a YouTube channel, like before, they said, you know, can you say hi to our vlog? And so he said hi, he was really sweet to them. And I was like, this is my chance, like, I'm not gonna let this go. So I was like, can you say hi? I had my phone, I was like, can you say hi to my vlog too or something? He's like, oh, you have a vlog too? And I didn't really know what to say, because he was like, what is your vlog called? So I was like, I don't really know what to say, because I don't really, like, it's Juls, baby, but like, I didn't really know what to say. So I was like, you could just say Juls. He was like, wait, what? And I was like, you could just say Juls. And so he said Juls, and it was really sweet. So I'll insert a clip of that here. I didn't want to tweet that out because I wanted to kind of save it for the video.
Can you say that on my vlog too?
Yeah, I'm taking a vlog too.
Oh, hello vlog.
You can say Juls.
What's your vlog called?
Just say Juls.
Juls. Hello Juls. I'm JTW and we're in this Sprite lounge.
And so then he left for a second so they could clear off the chairs, and he came back on and we got in pairs and just went up to talk to him and meet him.
Okay guys, so we're in line. Sorry, he's over there. So we're in line and we have to be in pairs and they're playing Mercy. I was so excited, and he said hi to my vlog, which you guys obviously just saw.
Can you put it on the back of this?
Oh, that's so cool.
I only have like 3 hours.
What was it? I don't know.
I got up there and I was like, he was like, hey. I was like, hey. And I said, I love your new song. Then he hugged Adriana, which is the girl I went up with. And then I said, I love your new song. And he's like, thank you. I'm really excited for you guys to hear the studio version, because we heard the acoustic version, not the studio version. And I was like, me too. I'm really excited. And we took a picture and I said, thank you so much. Thank you for coming to Chicago. And he's like, no, thank you guys for coming. And it was really sweet.
Yeah.
Thank you. I'm really excited for you guys. Cheers, you guys.
So anyway, so we left. They were like really kind of pushing us out because I guess they were like busy and stuff. So we just left and we waited down where we got picked up to go to the lounge. So where we were waiting before, because we thought maybe we'd see him like leaving. And so we did. So we were waiting there for like 5 minutes, and then he was leaving, and they were like, he's like, he didn't have that much time because he had to get to a flight. So he was like, I don't have that much time. And then he got, like, some of the other people I was with wanted to get videos for their friends. And I got something for someone that I'm not going to talk about right now, but I'm really excited about it. But he said hi really quickly to us again. It was really sweet. I had some pictures from that and I posted it on Twitter. So we said hi to him again. And I don't know, I don't feel like it wasn't like I spent 10 minutes talking to him, but I definitely, like, it was much more than just a quick meet. Like, he said hi to my vlog, like, he said my name, like, I, like, talked to him a little bit when we met him, and then we said hi again, like, after, like, it was really sweet, and I really, the best thing about this is how, like, chill it was. I feel like, he was obviously rushed to leave, but it was so, like, easy, and it wasn't, like, everything was so formal, because I guess it's because he's not so famous yet. Like, he's definitely famous, but he's not that famous yet. I know he's gonna get more famous, but he's not at that point yet. So I'm really, like, happy and lucky that I got to be there before he, like, really, really blew up. Because, like, these kind of things, they don't last forever. Like, with Sean, I don't think this would ever work. And so, obviously, with Sean, I regret not being there, like, supporting him when he was this small. Whatever, I can't change the past. But anyway, I'm glad that I got to be there. It was really, really fun and exciting. And I made some new friends. And it was just a great experience. So then after that, I hung out with the people I was with for a little longer.
She's really excited because she got a shout out for Jay. Okay, yeah, and he's on my vlog, but he was like, blog, Juls. So it's okay.
And then I just walked to meet my mom, and then we went home, and that was it.
Okay, guys, so we are on our way home. It'll take a while, but we're on our way home. This is my mother. I met up with her after, and want to say hi, so
hi.
Okay,
she doesn't typically let me talk.
Okay, anyway, so we're on our way home. It was really, really fun. I'm really happy this all happened, like, really, like, the best day ever. And yeah, thank you to my mom for letting me leave school early to do this, and thank you to Adriana for letting giving me the tickets and all that. And yeah, I had a lot of fun.
It was just really great. And I was like crying or anything, but I was just like, I was just so happy. I was just like, oh my god, this is great. Like, I was just so happy. Like, it was just It was really great. Like, I just went there for the pictures or just to, like, you know, say I met James UW. Like, I really, like, really like his music and I really like him. And I'm really happy that that happened because, oh, it was just a great experience. And he's just so sweet and so, like, down to earth and, like, real. He's not, like, caught up in, like, the fame or anything, like, whatever. So it was really sweet and I'm really happy that happened. And I'm so thankful to everyone that helped me get tickets, even if, like, it wasn't, like, even if the people who DM'd me originally, like, saying they had tickets, like, you guys, like, whatever. I'm so thankful for that because if it wasn't for you guys, I may not have known about the radio thing. So I'm thankful for everyone who tried to help me, or everyone who did help me, everyone who, like, contributed to this, because this was, like, one of the best days of, like, my life, I guess. And I'm never going to forget it, so thank you for everyone. And thank you for watching, because, yeah, thank you for watching. And I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you thought it was interesting. And I know I said on my Twitter that I do a Valentine's Day video, and I need to do this video first because I can't wait too long with this video, so I think I'm not going to do a Valentine's Day video this weekend. I'm really sorry about that, but I know a bunch of other people will, so you can just look at their videos, and I'll have a new video up next week, obviously. So yeah, make sure you're subscribed, make sure to give this video a big thumbs up, comment down below something nice, comment down below your favorite thing about James or Sean or something, or just comment something, you know, normal, nice or something, and comment some requests as usual, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!